things that people are talking a lot about is the Joker and that reveal. And Cameron obviously posted a photo on Instagram recently. What can you say about how long that path is going to play out on Gotham? Are we going to find out one way or the other whether he is actually the Joker this season, or is that a longer game you're playing?
You will find out, yes. It's difficult to talk about because it's one of those twisty stories. As soon as you start talking about it, it's like Perry Mason is leading you down to go, aha! the story will play itself out, not fully, but the fans will get a good dose of that Joker magic, and we'll learn the true origins of the Joker character this season.
So what other villains might we be seeing in season two?
Danny just mentioned Mr. Freeze is a definite. Who else? Tigress.
I mean, she's never had an origin story, so that's a good one. Azrael is a really good long, slow-burning origin story, and Hugo Strange.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
For now, yeah.
And as well, you know, there's those big kind of scary, epic villains like Azrael. There'll also be more, comedic is the wrong word, but more fun villains like Flamingo, for instance, might make an appearance. The fun of this world is that you can go from real, profound darkness to lightness in the same episode, in the same scene almost.
Talk about putting Bruce on the path to becoming Batman this season. Like, the way that you kind of thought it out, how to do this at the right pace to get him there when you need to get him there.
Yeah, it's tricky because it's like anyone's childhood. There's false dawns, there's wrong turns, and it's as much about watching David grow into himself and get older and become a man. And that's one of the beauties of working in TV, that it happens in time. Batman will grow as Bruce Wayne will grow as David grows. And as far as actually translating that onto the page, it's really just trying to be as organic and unforced as possible, and trying to... he's already had this traumatic turn. It's not... So what happens to him in the future is always going to be, you know, the texture of his life, as opposed to grand epic drama a secret drama that has happened outside of the Batman canon. As Danny said it many times, we're trying to make all of these characters as human and as real and as lifelike and as flawed and understandable as possible. So I don't know quite how to translate that, but that's essentially what we're doing.
So Bruce found a cave at the end of the pilot. We know what he's eventually going to turn that into, but what is the cave now?
Well, I don't know. Did your dad have a place in the house that you weren't allowed into, like the back garden shed?
Mine didn't.
No. Well, lots of dads do. And, you know, I think both, certainly Alfred, who had more of a sense of what's going on in the family, probably thought... got a few dirty magazines down there, or a little black book for the old girlfriends. Some kind of quotidian secret. I can't tell you what they really found down there, but it's a shock for both Bruce and Alfred, and it sets him off on... If he's not already set on the path he was on, it redirects him down a much more dangerous... more immediate path.
What's your version of Lucius Fox going to be like? Can you give us a sense?
He's played by a fine actor named Chris Chalk. With a character like that, again, you cast the best guy you can find, and is telling of the story. Lucius Fox is an old and close friend of Bruce's father, so he has a lot of there's a lot of knowledge about the Wayne Enterprises before Bruce was involved. And it's the beginning of a beautiful friendship. Just the friendship between a grown man and a kid. So it has all the kind of misunderstandings and conflict that you'll find in that sort of relationship.